I'm Adam Ward. I'm a professional freelance Lego artist.
Yeah, that is my real job.
I'm gonna help you build amazing Lego creations that make this world a little more awesome. This is Brick by Brick. Welcome back to another episode of Brick by Brick. I'm your host, Adam Ward, and today we're gonna teach you how to build something that will help you have more presence. And not present like it's a gift that you unwrap. Presence like being right here, right now. Say you invite a friend that you haven't seen in a long time out to dinner. You go and you sit down and you start talking. And what do? You put your phone on the table. Now doesn't it seem like it might be a little bit hard to concentrate on what the person across from you is saying when there's 20,000 other people vying for your attention on the table? So it's time to lock up our phones and turn that background noise way, way down. Phone, I hereby sentence you to one meal. Now it's time to build our cell phone jail. And it turns out it takes a ton of pieces to build the one that I designed. Now we're gonna run down the pieces on the screen, so I won't tell you how many of all of them, but here are the general pieces. A bunch of antenna, a bunch of one by one cones. We've got a ton of jumper plates. These are really cool. Now they're one by two, but there's only one dot on top. So they help you shift everything over a half brick. We've got a bunch of various sizes base plates. We've got 6x6s, 4x6s, 4x4s in gray and in red. You're gonna need a ton of 2x plates, 2x6s, 2x8s, 2x4s, 2x10s, whatever you got, grab them. You'll also need a bunch of 1x plates, 1x2, 1x4, 1x6, 1x8, a couple of tiles, and depending on how you want to design the top of your jail, you can use a ton of tiles, or if you want to keep that bumpy Lego look, you don't need to use many at all. And to make our jail door swing, this awesome 2x2 hinge. We use three of these. Now you only really need one, but if you use three, that hinge will be really strong. Because you don't want to have your phone doing a jailbreak. You ready? Let's build. Okay, we're gonna build this cell phone jail from the ground up. We're gonna start with the base.
Building a Lego jail for my cell phone. Building a...
Okay, so that's the base. Now, we flip the base over, take one of our hinges. When you make the hinge straight, see there's a little bump on the side? You want that facing in. Just like that. Door open, door closed. You have another hinge. Put it right on top. Right away, you'll feel the difference. Now we're gonna go all the way around the perimeter with 1x's. Now right on top of that perimeter we just did, we're gonna do another layer of jump plates. So our base is about finished. Now let's move on to the bars. The bars to our cell phone jail are made up of four pieces. Two antenna, and two of these 1x1 translucent cones. You take the cone, and you slide it all the way down. And if you're not sure if it's all the way down, you can go onto your table, just give it a little press. Then you take your second antenna and plop it on top. Once your second antenna is on top, take another small cone, same drill, all the way down. Now, to put our bars on our cell phone jail.
Now, we're gonna put our Lego jail aside for a second and work on the roof. Now we're gonna flip the ceiling over and do a border on the bottom. Now you wanna make sure that the side with the jumper plates, which will be the front, is open, so no bricks there. Okay, so this step is super important. You've got your perimeter down each side, all one by, but for the back of your jail, you need to use a two by. See, the two bys have these circles in the bottom of the plate, and the tops of the bars to your phone jail are gonna go right inside there. Just like that. So now the roof to our cell phone jail is practically finished. We're ready to put it on top of our jail. Bring it in, open up the door. You wanna just rest it on at first. You're gonna start with the very first bars. Ha! Our cell phone jail officially has a roof. Now to finish the front door. First move is take one of these large plates, a 2x10, put it on top of your cell bars. It's still a little bit wobbly. So if you've got the pieces, it's really nice to put a third hinge on the top. So first, we put one more layer of plates on top. Now, a whole row of jumper plates down the door. Now the hinge goes from that jumper plate to these two. Go across the roof with another row of jumper plates. There we go. Now our front cell door is almost finished. All we need to do is add a lock. And then it's up to you how you want to design it. Okay, so you might notice that on the top of the cell door, on one side, I used a 1x1 tile, and on the other side, a 1x1 plate. It wasn't an accident. On the side where we used the tile, that one's just gonna slide nice and easy. But on the side where we used the plate, we put our 1x2 tile on top, and now the door is locked. All you gotta do is take it off, and your phones are free to go. Whew, we did it. Jail completed. Congratulations, give me a high five through the screen. Nice job. Now, I'm gonna take this and test out on my friends. I don't think they'll fit in there though.
Soul Pancake, subscribe.
Whew, it was a really tough build today, but I had a great time. I hope you did too. I can't wait to see what you built. So, take a photo, take a video of you locking up your friends' phones, post it on our Facebook page. Be sure to subscribe so you can learn how to build even more things. Have a wonderful day. Be present. I'll catch you next time.